And these freezing temperatures need to be taken very seriously. This is dangerous, and we can prove it. Our crews discovered cases of hypothermia at local emergency rooms just today, and frostbite is also a big concern. News 4's Roseanne Coletti is live in East Harlem with information to help you stay safe. Roseanne?
It is so bitter and dangerous that hospitals in New York State have reported 145 cases, get this, 145 cases of hypothermia in a little over a week. New Yorkers who already move fast are moving even faster, and when you ask, how are you doing, they only have one word for it.
Very cold.
Very cold, and along with everyone else, also at risk for frostbite and worse. The emergency room here at St. Barnabas Hospital alone has already seen 9 cases of hypothermia this year, compared to last year's total of 11.
We're definitely seeing an uptick in our hypothermic patients, frostnip. Frostbite.
That frostbite can be both painful and ugly. Doctors here say one victim walked in after picking up recyclables in the cold for a few hours.
All 10 fingers were black. The tips of the fingers were black.
From frostbite.
From frostbite.
When your fingers start tingling or turning colors, time to warm them up. I noticed that you don't have your head covered.
That's true. I didn't want to get my hat dirty.
Doctors tell us keeping your head covered is very important because at least 25% of your body heat is lost through the head. Another factor that can chill you down is the wind chill factor. For example, with tomorrow's forecast in mind, temperatures at 5 degrees, winds howling at 30 miles per hour, the real feel would be minus 19, and within 30 minutes, exposed skin could be vulnerable to frostbite.
Wind chill plays a factor, an important factor in hypothermia or frostbite, because what it does is it comes in on exposed areas of skin, which have a large surface area. And what it does is it easily removes the heat from the body.
So layer up and don't linger in the cold. How are you bundled up there?
I'm doing the best I can.
You have layers on?
Yes.
Okay.
It's not enough.
And of course, those most at risk, doctors tell us, are those with perhaps underlying conditions or ailments, the elderly and children. We've been out here just a few minutes, and you can really feel it. Reporting live from the East Side, I'm Roseanne Coletti, News 4 New York.
All right, Roseanne, thank you. Very instructive.
Let's get back to the weather. The dangerous wind chills coming tonight and tomorrow can put you in the emergency room. So what happens if you come in with frostbite or hypothermia? News 4's Roseanne Coletti shows us.
As the deep freeze gets deeper, hypothermia cases are climbing in New York, with 145 reported by hospitals statewide in a little over a week. Here at St. Barnabas in the Bronx, nearly as many cases as all of last year, 2 while we were there.
We're definitely seeing an uptick in our hypothermic patients, frostnip, frostbite.
One of the first things they do in the ER is to get the patient out of cold and or wet clothing and into some warm attire. Now, this may look like an ordinary refrigerator, but it is a warming cabinet filled with warmed hospital gowns. It feels good, as well as warmed sheets and warmed blankets.
Then what we do is we establish intravenous access where we can give them warm IV fluids.
After that comes the bear hug. Think of it as a huge blow dryer with a disposable quilt.
While the patient is under here, the entire body is being heated. The temperature on the air being pumped in, a little over 100 degrees Fahrenheit. But it may take more than this to get the body temperature back to normal.
We will sometimes put in a tube down into the stomach and put warm water lavage in. We'll do the same thing with the bladder.
Extreme measures for extreme cold. Roseanne Coletti, News 4 in New York.